Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll guide you through the process of onboarding a Cisco Secure Firewall 1200 series threat defense device to cloud-delivered firewall management center. We'll demonstrate how to do this using zero-touch provisioning method. Zero-touch provisioning lets you onboard your threat defense device using its serial number without having to perform any initial setup on the device. Let's look at a deployment scenario to understand the zero-touch provisioning workflow. From a corporate office, an IT staff member initiates zero-touch provisioning using a security cloud control tenant. The necessary security policies and device configurations are set up and saved in cloud-delivered firewall management center, ready to be deployed to the device when it comes online. At the branch office, an operator powers on the threat defense device and connects the Ethernet 1 port to the network. The device then obtains an IP address from DHCP and connects to the internet. As soon as the device comes online, it reaches out to Security Cloud Control to associate with the tenant linked to its serial number. Security Cloud Control onboards the device and configures the cloud-delivered firewall management center as the device manager. Finally, the cloud-delivered firewall management center deploys the pre-configured security policies to the device. Now let's look at the prerequisites for onboarding the threat defense device. First, ensure that the cloud-delivered firewall management center is enabled on your Security Cloud Control tenant. The device must be in factory state and running threat defense software version 7.2 or later. Zero-touch provisioning is not supported on the earlier versions. You'll need an Ethernet cable to connect your device to the network. This connection will be outbound only, so there's no need to configure any internal network settings. The device will automatically obtain an IP address through DHCP and connect to the internet. Lastly, ensure that the network you want to connect your device has an active internet connection. Let's get started. Connect the threat defense device to a power supply and power it on. Next, with the Ethernet cable, connect the Ethernet 1 port of the device with your network. After the device completes its initial diagnostics and boots up, you'll notice the status LED at the back panel turning solid green. Make a note of the serial number of your device. You'll need it for the zero-touch provisioning process. You can find the serial number on the label of your device. Now let's onboard the threat defense device. First, log into your Security Cloud Control tenant to which you want to onboard the device. In the left navigation menu, click Security Devices. Next, click the blue plus button to onboard a new device and choose FTD as the device type. Choose the serial number onboarding method. Since we want to manage the device using cloud-delivered firewall management center when it is onboarded, choose cloud-delivered FMC from the Select FMC drop-down list. Enter your device's serial number and assign a name to easily identify it within your Security Cloud Control tenant. Because this device is brand new and has not been accessed before, you'll need to reset the default admin password. Enter the new password here and it will be assigned automatically once the device comes online. After that, select the access control policy that you want to deploy in the device. Choose the subscription licenses that you want to apply, and then click Next. This triggers zero-touch provisioning of the device. Its serial number is now linked to the Security Cloud Control tenant. You don't need to be logged into the Security Cloud Control portal during onboarding or keep an eye on its progress. For this demo, let's now check the progress of device onboarding. Go back to the Security Devices page. When the device is connected to the Cisco Cloud, the connectivity status next to the device will change to online. You can also verify the cloud connection status by looking at the Manage Status LED at the back panel of the device. The Manage Status LED will slowly flash in green, indicating that the device is connected to the Cisco Cloud. Security Cloud Control then starts provisioning the device, which can take up to 20 minutes to complete. When the configuration status changes to synced, the device is successfully onboarded and ready to be managed. If the configuration status does not update promptly, click the refresh icon. The Manage Status LED at the back panel of the device will now change to solid green. If you see the Manage Status LED flashing in green and amber, the cloud connectivity has failed. If this occurs, check your network connectivity. If you encounter any issues during this process, refer to the Security Cloud Control documentation. Thank you for watching this video. Please share your feedback and suggestions for our upcoming videos.